Hello friends, in this video, we are going to talk about the basic principle of radar, the advantage disadvantage offered by radar system, and what is the basic block diagram of radar system. So let's begin with the topic. In this video, we are going to cover the following topics, and the topics are definition of radar, general usage of radar, limitations and advantages. Then next is basic principle of radar. And we are going to conclude the topic with some MCQs. So let's start with basic definition of radar. The radar is basically stands for radio detection and ranging equipment. The radar was initiated originally in World War II, during which there was a need for military to keep eye on the enemy's activities and enemy's movement. So the development of radar at that time was acts as an electronic eye for keeping watch on the enemy's movement and enemy's actions. Slowly, the radar find application in other fields also. Originally, the radar was developed to find its application only in the military applications. But after that, slowly, radar can be used in the application like remote sensing application, where it is used to predict the weather. It is also used for observing the weather condition. It is also used to map the route for the ships. Then it can be also used in air and oil exploration. It is used in the road safety application. It is also used to measure the speed of vehicle on the highways. That is, the enforcement of law and highway safety can also be achieved by using the radar application. For guiding missiles and for fusing weapons, the radar can be used. In spacecraft applications and aircraft applications, also the radar finds its own applications. So these are the some basic applications of radar system. So after evaluation of radar, the radar technologies went on developing on its own superior technology to fulfill the efforts to fulfill the requirement of modern communication system. And therefore, radar can also be used in industrial communication system. The radar system provides better and reliable communication in this era of applications. Now moving back to the basic principle operation of radar, the radar is basically an electromagnetic system which is used for detecting and locating the reflecting object. The object may be a spacecraft, it may be an aircraft, it may be a moving vehicle, or it may be a people, or it may be a moving animal. So, the radar basically operates on the principle of transmitting the signal and receiving the signal back in the form of echo. Therefore, it is very much important in the radar system to have a reflector or to have a target which is having good capability of reflection signal. Whenever the electromagnetic signal incidents on the object, then the object must have an ability to reflect the signal back to the transmitter of the radar system so that the transmitter can detect the position of the radar. Therefore, it is very much important in the radar system to have a target or object having enough strength to send the signal back in the same direction from which it is received. And therefore, if the receiver is not able to receive the signal, then it may possible that the radar system may stops operating and the communication comes to an end. So from this discussion, we will come to know that there are several disadvantages of the radar system. And the disadvantages are, first of all, the radar system totally based on the operation of reflecting mechanism. If the object or a target is not able to reflect the signal back to the receiver, then it is not possible for the radar system to detect the location and position of the target, and therefore the communication may get interrupted. The second disadvantage of the radar system is that initially when the radar system was originated, at that time it is not possible for the radar system to detect the colors, or we can say the radar system was color blinded. But nowadays, by using various adaptive signal processing technique, the color detection technique can also be implemented in the radar system. The third disadvantage related to the radar system is nothing but the transmitted signal cannot be operated on water bodies, or we can say the signal cannot penetrate deep into the water bodies or the thick metal sheet, and therefore it put restriction on the application of radar. The application where we require to find out the object and in underwater condition, at that time we cannot use the radar system. So these are the few disadvantages of the radar system. But irrespective of this disadvantage, there are several advantages provided by the radar system. For example, the radar system can be used in daytime as well as in nighttime. The radar system can be used in any weather condition or in any season. The radar system can be used in fog condition, it can be used in cloudy condition, it can be used in rainy condition, it can be used in haze. Therefore, there is no restriction on the use of radar on the basis of the condition or weather conditions. Now, moving towards the block diagram of the radar system, it is very much important that the magnitude or the strength of the received signal required to be enough high so that the radar system can able to detect the location and position of the moving object. The radar system can be used for a longer distance or it can be used for a shorter distance also. Usually, the microwave signals are used for transmission of the signal. Now, the block diagram of radar consists of. From the figure, we will come to know that it consists of only two blocks, that is, transmitter and receiver. Along with transmitter and receiver, there is an antenna which is considered as a common antenna, and the antenna is called as duplexer or transceiver. The antenna is able to perform the function of both. It performs the function of transmission of the signal as well as it performs the function of receiving of the signal, and therefore it is called as duplexer. So basically the duplexer or transceiver is a device which is able to perform the function of transmission of the signal as well as reception of the signal. When the duplexer or a transceiver is controlled by transmitter, then it acts as a transmitting antenna, and when it is controlled by receiver, then it acts as a receiving antenna. Now, in case of radar system, the electromagnetic signals are transmitted into the space in the form of short pulses of the sine wave, and these pulses are get transmitted towards the object. Now, these pulses, out of the total transmitted signal or out of the total radiated energy, few or some amount of energy is get reached to the target or object, and remaining amount of energy it gets scattered or re-radiated into the space in different directions. Now, after reaching to the target, the energy is get reflected back along with the energy which is re-radiated into the space. So, that energy is get received by the receiver antenna and forwarded to the receiver. Now, receiver calculate this energy or process this energy in order to detect the presence or in order to detect the location of the moving object. Now, from the block diagram, we will also come to know that it is very much easy to develop a transmitter rather than developing receiver with an antenna, because the signal received by antenna is again forwarded to the receiver, and the signal requires to be having higher strength as compared to the transmitted signal. But usually, the magnitude of the received signal is less than the magnitude of the transmitted signal, because when the signal is traveled from transmitter to target and from target to receiver, the signal may get attenuated. Therefore, in radar system, the signal follows two-way path. During this two-way path communication, because of the environmental factor, the signal energy may get attenuated, and therefore, the magnitude of the signal which is transmitted is always higher than the magnitude of the received signal. The distance or location, or we can say the range of the object, is calculated by calculating the two-way path time, or we can say the propagation time required for the signal for completing two-way path. That means the time taken by the signal to travel from transmitter to the target and time taken by the signal to again travel from target to receiver is considered as total time period, and this total time period is used for detecting the distance or used for detecting the range of the object. Also, the location of the object in any angle can be obtained from the direction in which the narrow beam width of the antenna is pointing and magnitude of the strength of the signal is high. So, in this way, the object location and presence of the object is get detected by the radar system. The object may be moving or the object may be a stationary. If the object is moving, then in that case, the output frequency, or we can say the signal frequency, is get shifted due to the Doppler's effect. And if the object is stationary, then there will be no deviation in the frequency of the received signal. Most of the time, the Doppler frequency shift radars are used in many of the cases. So this is how basically the radar system operates. Now let's move on to some MCQs. The first question is, the radar cannot operate in the following conditions. And the conditions, and that means the options are, first, raining and snowing and night condition. Deep water submerged targets. Third option is absorbing target natures. Now, we know that irrespective of any weather condition or irrespective of any season condition, radar can operate in all the conditions. But there is a limitation on the radar usage. The radar signal or the transmitted signal cannot penetrate deeper into the water bodies. And therefore, here we can say the option is nothing but option B. deep water submerged target. So we cannot use radar in the underwater applications. The next question is, in order to facilitate common antenna in transmit and receive operation, the radar makes use of, the options are modulation operation, coding operation, pulsed waveform with duplexer unit, and last one is diversity operation. Now we know that the transmitted signal is transmitted in the form of short pulses of sine wave, and the antenna which is used in the radar system is a duplexer. Basically, duplexer is a unit which is able to perform the operation of both transmission as well as reception depending upon which unit is going to control the duplexer. If transmitter controls the duplexer, then it able to perform function of transmission of signal, and if the receiver is controlling the duplexer, then it acts as a receiving antenna. Therefore, here we can say the option number C is considered as a right option. That means in order to facilitate common antenna in transmit and receive operation, the radar makes use of pulsed waveform with duplexer unit. So this is what about the basic fundamental principle of the radar operation, in which we covered the advantages, disadvantages of the radar system, applications of radar system, and evaluation of radar system along with basic block diagram operation. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda. Subscribe Ikeda. Thank you.